about 20, 22 kilos there.
It's this heavy.
We're guessing.
It's that heavy. It's like heavier than a normal sandbag that I'd use, so it's definitely heavier than 20.
Yeah.
But we don't know how much heavier.
Yeah. So we
just know when we pick it up, it makes you go, oh,
that's heavy.
That's heavy. So that's our weighted sandbag. Make sure you're using something pretty similar. Fill a rucksack, whatever you've got. I'm taking all your ass. If you have a core band, not necessarily.
Strings. I'm also going to smash your quads. So what I want you to do is get the heaviest weights that you've got. That's it. Get the heaviest weights that you've got. They can be kettlebells, they can be dumbbells, they can be anything you can find in the house that is heavy. And we are going to focus on pauses. So we're going to focus on time under tension. We're going to take out the momentum of the move, which makes you work a lot harder. We're going to go laterally, we're going to go curtsy lunge, we're going to go squats, goblet squats. All of it. Basically, that's it. So I'm taking on as much as I can to isolate your quads and your hamstrings, and Lisa is going to smash your ass.
So we've got 16 kilogram kettlebells, 20 kilogram kettlebells, and then there's a bar set over there with 20 pounds aside, including the bar, 46 pounds. Okay, so that's going to be for curtsies. It's easier to do curtsies with a bar just because it keeps your body upright. So if you have a bar that you can set aside,
it is a lot easier. It keeps your shoulders back, keeps your chest up, and it's a lot easier for your balance, especially when you start to get tired. If you're holding something here, whether it's a kettlebell or a dumbbell or by your side, when you start to get tired, people have a tendency to roll through their shoulders and roll through their toes. If you've got a bar on your back, it'll help you to keep yourself in your heels, keep your weight central, and help you with your balance.
Yeah.
Plus, it's nice to have some variation.
It is.
Just use the same.
We haven't been doing for
quite a while. You're going to want your chalk, you probably might want your straps, and you might want your belt if you've got one. If you haven't got any of these things, it's fine.
It's fine.
If you've got them though, get it all on.
Yeah, we're ready to go. I'm ready to go. You ready?
50 seconds work, 15 seconds rest. We've got 15 seconds rest because when Lisa's putting that ridiculous band on and we're on and off trying to sort herself out, trying to swap over, inevitably, I need 5 seconds longer just to get myself.
When you're taking your niggas off,
yeah,
it takes a while.
Seconds fine after the first two or three. It's when your second round's in and your legs are like jelly and you wonder if you can get there on time. So I've begged and I've pleaded and I've given us a 5 seconds.
5 more seconds! I know. So excited. I'm very nervous about this, not going to lie. We are both a little bit tired today.
And also, we're going straight in.
Yeah.
Just going to put this out there, we're going straight in. So, if you think, oh God, you know what, I'm going to go through the first one or two with no weight, just go through the actual routine with no weights and use it as warm up, that's fine. But we are going straight in there.
We're warm already. We've already done our warm up, we're on it. If you haven't warmed up, you know you need to do at least 5 minutes, 10 minutes, just skip in or whatever you normally do. Stop this video now and get that in because you will regret it if you don't. Or like Teresa said, do the first couple of rounds with no weight. We're ready to roll, that's talking over.
Let's do this.
Oh my God, I don't want to. 15 seconds, I'm setting the timer.
So if you are starting with me, we are going for paused rep kettlebell squats.
If you start with me, we're just gonna put it on our on our hips, we're just gonna thrust it until we go in, like that.
No easy option here.
No easy option. Ready?
You are not getting an easy option.
15 seconds.
Paused rep, so when you are squatting, you have the kettlebells by your feet, okay? You're coming down with a pause, driving up, squeezing your glutes under hard before you go again. That is the idea of a pause.
3, 2, 1, so you come down, squeeze up. Now, make sure it is your hips that are doing the work, and those ass cheeks.
You'd be surprised how much you can actually thrust. So big explosive power on these squats. Make sure you have that pause at the bottom and then drive through the heels, squeeze the glutes as well.
30 seconds.
I'm done already.
I'm over it.
Show you from the side. Make sure your shoulders are back when you come up. Down we go. Pause it.
like we're happy, you know, that we didn't have them. We only had 16s, kind of regretting buying them now. Ready. make sure you're up and tall. Don't let that chest arch. Lift your chest high. Up, push off with that leg. Good. This feels so rubbery, it makes me warm.
Focus on those glutes if you're with me. Focus on that squeeze at the top. Tiny pause for a second.
Get up. Get up, 28. Make sure the weight is even as well. 22.
16. So we're going to hold it behind the chest, we're going to come down with a pause, drive up and squeeze your bum under. Lovely. Let's do this. Make sure you've got full control of that kettlebell, chest up, abs in. We're going to come down and pause it. Drive up, squeeze your glutes under. Go. Squeeze up. Drive through with those hips. 36. Have that pause.
Ah.
Keep all the weight in those heels. 30 seconds. Don't let it beat you. Think of that ass. Keep those little bend in your knees. Don't let your legs rock out at all so that all the stress, all that tension stays.
lower. Go to where you stop and then go a bit lower down. Oh yeah, now you felt it. Yeah, that's where it should be. What were you doing before? 20. Oh, that's a new noise. I've never heard Jesus make that noise before.
Ah, little bum cheeks.
That noise, I've never heard Jesus make that. 4, 3, 2,
last one. So we've got curtsy to the right to do. Oh, bum. 5. Remember to use your belt to give you some back support if you need it. 30 seconds.
No! Ah.
Oh my gosh. Who needs to sit down anyway? 15 seconds. Come on, keep that momentum.
Hold the squeeze for the last 10, you ready? Go, hold it, squeeze. About this workout, you're getting all the legs, not just a bit of the legs, all of them getting smashed out in one go.
30.
Oh. Can you feel it on your arse? Then I'd like to see a little bit lower, please. Go low. Yeah, that's where I want it. Now you're working. 15.
Get ready for that 10-second hold at the top. Here it comes. Up we go, pause, squeeze, and then squeeze that little bit harder, chin tucked in, squeeze, 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 hold
three,
it,
two,
hold it.
One.
Oh, is that one round done?
That is one round done.
Hooray! Oh.
Oh. One round done, get a drink.
Grab yourself a drink, get some chalk.
Get your bum cheeks.
You need some chalk on.
Oh.
You need to split your legs. If you can't split your legs and keep it there, pointless. Are ready? So, you should have had a drink. We are back to paused reps with the squats. So, I'm back to my 20 kilo kettlebells. Heavy, remember. Pause at the top, pause at the bottom.
Ready?
I'm ready.
15 seconds.
On your board or on the floor, you're going to lift one leg. And you're going to squeeze up and down, making sure that that leg is on the heel of the foot.
2, 1.
I don't want to do it already.
Let's go. Pin those shoulders back.
If you need to touch the foot or reset, do it.
Pause at the bottom.
You feel this on your hamstrings as well. Oh my God, I can't even keep my leg up. Need to reset your leg, it's okay.
Make sure you get that pause at the bottom and not bouncing those kettlebells off the floor. floor and making yourself stop.
20 seconds, explosive power up.
Come on, driver, we're gonna beat ya.
My ass cheek.
13.
Come on, one more. Big drive, abs in.
5 seconds, one more.
Imagine you're sitting on a chair. Sit on that chair, waving the heels.
35.
Bum cheeks.
Yes.
Fire.
It's horrible. 24.
Squeeze. Tiny pause at the top. Keep that tension through that bum cheek for a second. Make sure you're squeezing the ass cheeks at the top. It's all about the cheeks.
5, can we get one more in? Flick those hips up. Rest it.
I'm sweating now. So now we're working on those small fibers. Big fibers.
Lateral lunge. One more.
For those of you that don't know, Teresa actually teaches a legs class.
Yesterday, was it?
Yesterday, the day before.
Day before.
So this is horrendous for her.
Yeah.
So I'm going to put my band up over my thing so I don't have to keep taking it off. Yeah, I just thought that.
Work on your depth, work on your form, and the rest will take care of itself.
Think about your ass pulling your
out and in, and your inner and out thighs. Imagine you've got a ball in the middle of your legs and you're trying to squeeze it in and out. Don't just let your ankles roll. I don't want that. It's got to get to the point where your outer thighs and your outer ass cheeks are burning.
10 seconds.
And this is about now. So down to the last 10, you should start to feel where we're working now.
Press down.
All that ass cheeks. Time. On the next one, we're doing that again, but with the bag. You're welcome. 3, 2. Let's go other side. Let's go. Squeeze. It's like you've got it in stereo.
Squeeze it in. What's that?
Yeah.
A little bit higher. Squeeze.
Is that song about stereo?
Don't let those knees come in. You need to work against that band as well, making it even harder. 20. And the band really does make a difference. Curtsy and get that back leg nice
and fart across that front. Some weight into them. Don't rush them and get in low. Rest it.
Don't want to.
We do. Come on, let's do it.
Let's go. Straight thrusts.
Let's go. Curtsy. Keep the bend in the knees.
Straight thrusts. Let's go. Finish it. Now hold it and squeeze for five. Take it down. You should be squeezing that hard in a little. Squeezing that squeeze. Down, 28.
Keep that core engaged all the time doing these.
21. Whichever leg you like, make sure the front leg is nice and straight, bending the back leg, hinge it forward, feel the stretch on the back of that front leg, make sure your shoulders stay back, your chest is tall, push your bum back, drag and pause.
If you're with me, get your band, it shouldn't be too heavy. One foot on your bench, keep your
control of these kettlebells.
With these bands, you know, they start to get warm.
Yeah,
they start moving, don't they? Crazy, I've got some ones up my back. They're helpful. 30 seconds.
Don't let your legs pull too close together because then the band will start to move. You need to keep that tension on the band. Squeeze up at the top and down. Squeeze up. That back should be really flat.
You've got 15 seconds. Remember, it's a stretch down the back of the front leg we're looking for. Rest it. Bend those knees. Rest it.
Change sides. Let's do it again.
Change sides.
Change sides.
5 seconds. Oh, they get your heart rate up. Grab those kettlebells.
One side is going to be way more excited about this behavior than the other.
Push that bend on the right back. Just turn the side slightly.
So the idea is you're not going any higher than the ass cheek and you're in line with the body. So if you're doing a bird dog in yoga like that, and you squeeze that cheek, squeeze, but that hip is working as well.
Might be an idea to get your straps for this one, guys, because if you're going heavy and you're maxing out, it's a long time to hold on to that weight.
Good clean. It gets you right on that last turn, doesn't it? 10.
Rest
it. Last one. Oh, it gets you right on that last turn. Choke up. Stab it. Now put your back leg a little bit higher.
I think.
Yeah. Is it roll?
No, it's just you can't get the move in the leg.
Okay. Let's go. Staggered. Stick that ass back. Show me that ass. I'm watching you. Let's go.
If you're with me, focus on that squeeze where you extend that leg out. Squeeze the bum cheek before you're going to come down again. Squeeze and pause. Squeeze.
If you can't feel it on the back of the leg, make sure that ass cheek is going back first.
30 seconds. Squeeze.
Good. Come on, push. You've got to make sure that we're working the whole leg. 18. It'll get you back now, Therese. 15. Don't let them shoulders fall forward, get them back. 10. 6. 3.
4. Oh. Yeah, geez, hamstrings.
All of it.
Switch sides.
Good times.
It's actually really nice just to get some fluid movement, but they're sneaky.
Yeah.
Because like that, they just hit you and they've got you, then they burn. Let's go. Especially if you can get that pause.
Remember, stick the bum back of that straight-ish leg. You should have a slight bend in the knee. And your elbow, your shoulder should not be falling in.
Never underestimate the power of the band.
feeling that now, starting to get very, very tight.
Yes!
This time we alternate. We go lift, lift, tip up, squeeze, lift, lift, so you keep your legs up. Squeeze, squeeze, take it down, squeeze up, squeeze, so you're holding that squeeze when you do each separate one. Squeeze it, squeeze, squeeze, take it down.
Here, heavy. So, talking, there's a class going on in the other room. So if you hear other people talking, that's what it is. But just don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. Yeah. It is what it is. They do them.
What are you using?
For paused. You've got all the chalk on your hand. All the chalk.
She's literally got just a hand of chalk. So
I'll take any bit of help I can get today.
I think I'm going to do 16. My class is killing me. 16, 3. Just give me 1 second. Just gonna get quiet.
Come on, it's supposed to be tough.
Yeah.
Let's go. We're in this together, let's finish it. 10.
Make sure you're doing pigeon, stretch all of it, everything.
Oh, those legs.